So silence helps to surrender, and silence also makes a student open to knowledge. Our older tradition in the Gurukul system is such that a student does not speak in front of the teacher until asked. And even if the student has to ask a question, the student waits for the teacher's permission. One doesn't ask the question just like that, because there has to be a tuning that has to happen between the teacher and the student. And then the teacher gives that space and that freedom. Okay, now you ask the questions. So earlier days, the practice of a spiritual seeker was to practice silence. To gain knowledge, silence is a very, very important prerequisite. Otherwise, knowledge will not remain. If the mind is disturbed, I may hear, but nice cross ventilation will happen. It should go inside. Only silence will make that possible. I remember when I went to study Vedant course, for 1 month, Puja Guruji, Swami Tejomanandji, he stayed in Pavai Ashram and he was taking Tattva Bodh for us. So he used to come, take the class, go back to the kutia. We never were allowed to go to his kutia. For a long time, we were not allowed to go to the kutia there. Other devotees and all, they come, meet Guruji and go. But we as students, we are not allowed to go to the kutia for a certain time, for a few months. So I happened to go there because they told, Guruji used to take notes of all of us and he would go through. So I happened to go there, take the notes and give it to Guruji. So it was like 15th day or something. I gave the notes and then I turned, I did prostration and then I was going. But I had a question in my mind. So I turned back and I said, Guruji, can I ask a question? And Guruji said, now, it's not even 15 days over and you already want to ask questions. Wait. Listen. When the time comes, then you will ask. Then ask the question. So a student in the traditional days was not allowed to ask a question, because what question will I ask? Empty mind will make more noise. One has not even heard anything much properly, and one is already starting questions. So silence was a practice of the seeker in the earlier days, and they never used to speak in front of the teacher. So by itself, that was a sadhana for them. Carry on. So silence makes a person more receptive, more alert to the knowledge aspect. This is a beautiful quote of a Swamiji from Ramakrishna Mission. His name is Swami Paramananda. Two beautiful quotes. One is, we can never hear the voice of the soul if our ears are filled with the loud noises of the world. And second one, those who have obtained the direct vision of the truth are not inclined to make their own voice heard. Hence you will find that so many Mahatmas, they become quiet. Because they experience such deep silence within themselves that they don't even feel the need to speak.